Good morning, dear students. In our today's class, let us study about water pollution and conservation. Class 4, Environmental Science. What is this? This is water. What are the uses of water? We use water for our different daily day activities like drinking, washing hands, brushing teeth, taking bath, cooking, watering plants, etc. What are the sources of water? From where do we get the water? From ocean, lake, pond, river, streams. Now we see here there are two glasses of water. Here are two glasses of water. Which glass of water will you drink and why? Obviously, you will select the first one. Why? Because it is pure water. What about the water in the second glass? It is impure water. What do you see in this picture? The water is polluted. The polluted water. You see one more image of polluted water. What is polluted water? That is nothing but the impure water. You can see one more image of polluted water, how the factories are leaving out the polluted water to the river pond so that the water in the river and pond gets polluted. What are the different causes for water pollution? One is industrial waste. The waste water from the industries are given out to the river, ocean and all so that the water in the river and ocean gets polluted. At home also, sometimes we leave the wastewater to the river or the pond or the lake. Hence it gets polluted. And the agricultural waste. You see a different pictures. These are the causes for water pollution. Causes for water pollution. What happens if there is water pollution? All the aquatic animals living in the water will die. You can see in the images the death of fish. Why? Because the water is polluted. Impure water, if there is impure water, the fishes or the other animals which are in the water will die. You can see more images. Even the birds, if the birds are drinking that water, impure water, the birds will die. What happens when you drink the impure water? See the effects of water pollution here. First one, as I already said, the death of fish or animals. What happens if you drink the polluted water? You will get diseases. You will get diseases. What is the main disease that we get if we drink impure water? The disease is cholera. The disease is cholera. You see a person suffering from cholera. In cholera, what happens? It is a disease that causes a severe watery diarrhea. You will get diarrhea which lead to the dehydration, even the death if untreated. If a person drinks the impure water or the polluted water, he will get a disease called cholera. It is an infectious disease, spreads from person to person. And a person suffering from cholera will have diarrhea. Diarrhea leads to dehydration. What is dehydration? The amount of water in your body gets decreased. When the amount of water in your body is decreased, that causes dehydration. Clear? It is dehydration. It is caused by eating food or drinking water that is contaminated water with the bacteria called Vibrio cholerae. Vibrio cholerae. That bacteria causes cholera. You see here a person suffering from cholera. What are the symptoms of cholera? One is vomiting, low blood pressure, diarrhea, rapid weight loss, increased thirst, loss of skin elasticity. Know this. Diseases like cholera are spread to water. If not treated properly in time, it can lead to death. In the case of vomiting and diarrhea, the body loses water content and the patient becomes tired. This is called dehydration. To avoid dehydration, a mixture of salt, sugar, lemon juice is boiled and cooled. Water should be given to the patient. This is called rehydration. As I told you already, what happens if there is cholera? There will be continuous diarrhea. If there is diarrhea, what happens? Water content in our body is lost. Water content in our body is lost. And the patient becomes very tired. That condition is dehydration. Now, how to overcome this dehydration? What you have to do? You have to take little salt, sugar, lemon juice, add it to the water, boil it. After boiling, cool it. After cooling, you have to give it to the person, one who is suffering from dehydration caused due to cholera. Then we call this process as rehydration. Rehydration. This rehydration, what happens in rehydration? This fills water in a body. What you have to do, you have to mix. If there is no lemon juice, you can just mix sugar and salt to the water. Boil it, cool it and drink it. It is good for rehydration, rehydrating of the body. Now see here, what is dehydration? They have given, dehydration occurs when you use or lose more fluid than you take in and your body doesn't have enough water and other fluids to carry out its normal functions. That is dehydration. Now what is rehydration? The process of restoring lost water for a person suffering from dehydration. A person who has lost water from the body due to diarrhea is given rehydration. What you have to do to give rehydration? You have to mix salt, sugar to the water, boil it, cool it, then drink it. It is good for rehydration. ORS. You might have seen such packets given it contains a powder that is mixed with water and given to the person suffering from diarrhea. This is called as ORS. What is mean by ORS? It is oral rehydration solution. Oral rehydration solution. These packets are easily available in the medical store. What we have to do is, it contains a powder that you have to mix with water, then give it to the person suffering from rehydration. What is ORS solution used for? Oral rehydration solution, simply we call it as ORS, are used to treat rehydration caused by diarrhea. If a person is suffering from diarrhea, that leads to the dehydration, so you have to give ORS to the such person. Now few points to remember. Now to control the pollution, the government has started Pollution Control Board. Pollution Control Board is a government organization established to prevent the quality of water. Government has established Pollution Control Board. A chemical called chlorine is added to the water to purify it from germs and then supplied to the houses in towns and cities. Normally in towns and cities we get the water from a river, isn't it? Even river might contains harmful germs in it. So what they will do is they will add a chemical called as chlorine to the water. The chlorine purifies the water by killing germs in it and then that water is supplied to the towns and cities. When we boil water, all the bacteria will die. It is good for health to boil and cool the water and you have to drink it. So before drinking the water, don't drink the cold water. You have to boil the water, then cool it, then drink it. It is very good for health also. So hence we have come to the end of the chapter, Water Pollution and Conservation. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.